What is foiling and scaling on membrane filtration? Foiling and scaling are one of the biggest challenges in water treatment industry for membrane filtration. Today, I will explain to you how to understand your source water can make foiling or scaling on your membrane filtration and how you can use longer your membranes. Hi, this is David from Chanka Water Treatment. First of all, I explain what is foiling and foiling types and scaling. Foiling, you know, reverse osmosis, pressure-driven process. We make pressure on water and force it to pass semi-permeable membrane. The foiling of pressure-driven membranes is generally referred to the accumulation, deposition, or adsorption of foulants onto the surface of membrane or within the membrane pores, which can cause the basic membrane function not work properly, such as overfiltration time, reducing permeate flow, filtration efficiency, and pressure drop across the membrane. Generally, when permeate flow rate reduces, water plant operator increases the pressure, but it causes increasing the foiling speed at membrane. So we don't use membrane as long as possible. Don't worry. I will explain step by step and you will learn how to use membrane longer. But first of all, you have to understand mechanism of foiling and scaling. Membrane foiling is influenced by three major factors. One, membrane material properties. Example, hydrophilicity, roughness, and electrical charge. Second, water character depends on the feed water analysis report. Example, concentration of the foulant, turbidity, total suspended solids. And the operating conditions, foiling increased by high pressure operation. Here, I want to tell you something. We face this problem so often at customer side. I understand customer wants to get best price in market. And if customer doesn't have enough knowledge about reverse osmosis system, he just tell to supplier needed capacity as liter per hour. Most of professional water treatment supplier first ask, what is water source and do you have water analysis report? If customer doesn't understand the meaning of how this question is important, just focus on price and try to buy cheapest solution, they are buying wrong system. After using the system, maybe foiling, maybe scaling problem occur, flow rate dramatically reduces in short time and operator increase the pressure, membrane was clogged and cannot be used again. Maybe pump is also corrupted. Then customer is thinking China product is quality not good if they buy from China. As Chang'e, we never give proposal if customer doesn't have water analysis report. Don't forget, good things are not cheap and cheap things are seldom good. Foiling types. As you can see in this picture, there are three types of foiling in the membrane. Biofouling, colloidal foiling, and organic foiling. Now we see what are they. Biofouling. Biofouling is very closely related to living or microorganism in the feed water that attach onto the membrane surface. In general, the attached microorganism tend to grow rapidly by forming biological film at the presence of nutrients in the feed water. So biofouling put another barrier on membrane and increase the membrane resistance in the same time. Biofilm causes hydrolysis process in membrane layer. It means polymer degradation, kill your membrane. Colloidal foiling. Colloidal foiling occurs when suspended solids or colloidal material clog holes of a membrane or stick to its surface. As particles accumulate on the membrane, they form a cake layer that obstructs water from flowing through the membrane pores. As a result, increased pressure differential measurement and increase energy consumption. Organic foiling. Organic foiling is the combination of deposition, reactions, and interactions of high molecular weight organic molecules. For example, natural organic matters with the membrane surface. These organic matters usually consist of humic substances, polysaccharides, proteins, lipids, nucleic acid and amino acid, organic acid, and cell components. As you see, foiling is coming from organic matters. Scaling is a kind of foiling because of inorganic matters. Scaling. Scaling can be described as coatings on the membrane formed by inorganic crystallization. Usually they only occur with nanofiltration and reverse osmosis membrane. If the solubility limit of dissolved salt is exceeded, You can see hard crystal form coat layer on membrane. You understand what is folding and scaling, and now we can talk about how we can minimize if there is organic and inorganic chemicals cause folding or scaling in your feed water. First thing you have to do, you send your water to laboratory for test and get the test result. Folding and scaling can be minimized by appropriate membrane selection, choice of operating conditions, pretreatment system, membrane cleaning system, CIP, clean in place. Then check the test report as regards to your water source and the total dissolved solids, TDS. If you don't know what is TDS, please watch this video, I put a link. You can decide which membrane type is suitable for your application. If your water is brackish water, you must choose brackish water type membranes. If your water is seawater, you must choose seawater type membranes. When we check your water analysis report, we design system as regards to working pressure and flow rate. And you have to follow our design operation conditions. To increase working pressure, to get more yield from system, can cause folding and scaling problem. Also, when you check your water analysis report, you will see TSS, total suspended solids, and turbidity value. Now we see what is the effect of this value on water. Turbidity and TSS can cause folding problem on membrane, and you can prevent your system by applying pretreatment, such as coagulation, flocculation, sand filter, carbon filter, remove suspended solids and matter in your water and prepare water to membranes. The other method is CIP system to clean, wash membrane in membrane housing without taking them out automatically. You can use acid and bases to remove foulants. For scaling, I teach you one old school method, easily to understand. If there is folding or scaling problem in your water, normally we are using software like Rosa Wave or something else. From this software, it gives you warning there is a scaling problem and you adjust this one just one click and it gives you solution. But you are end user and you don't use this software. So old school method is good for you to understand it. Here there is a table. How we will use this table? Okay, please follow carefully. You have water analysis report and you want to understand is there any scaling problem in your membrane? To happen calcium sulfate scaling. Our calcium level must be higher than 751 milligram over liter or ppm. Ppm and milligram over liter is same unit. And sulfate must be higher than 1799 milligram over liter. So from the test report, our calcium is 1020 milligram over liter. Sulfate is 9950 milligram over liter. So there is calcium sulfate scaling problem. Or we check other aluminum hydroxide. In test report, aluminum is 0.5 milligram over liter. It is higher than 0.37 milligram over liter. And pH is 7.5. It is higher than 3. So there is potential for aluminum hydroxide scaling. Such as now we check, is there any potential for strontium sulfate scaling? Sulfate is 9950 milligram over liter. It is higher than 69 milligram over liter. But strontium is just 22 milligram over liter. It is less than 63. So we don't have this risk. To minimize scaling and folding, there are a lot of choice in the market on chemical side. To suggest which one is fixed to your problem, we have to see your water analysis report. But I will leave a link in description. It is our webpage. From there, you can get chemicals name. Thanks for watching our video. Please don't forget to subscribe and like. Bye-bye.